Yeah, hi. Now we have a presentation about a material with a special functionality. Let's say them smart material. We have been showing these kind of smart materials here at Subcontractor in our exhibition for quite a long time. And what surprised us most in the last year was a report about a material, a magnet material, which you can cool or use it for cooling processes in the industry. And now we have the inventor of this material in our program. He is from Vakuumschmelze in Hanau in Germany. So let's have a warm welcome to Matthias Katter. Hi, Matthias. Hi.
Hello.
What is the secret behind your innovation, and how does it work?
Yeah, first of all, the innovation is not only from me. It's an old story. Magnetocaloric or magnetic cooling is invented, I would say, in the 20s of the 19th, 20th century. At that time, it was used only for very low temperatures to cool down to Kelvin and sub-Kelvin. Even in 1926, it was honored with a Nobel Prize because it was the first time where the people could reach really low temperatures. For a long time, it was only used in scientific environment, but beginning of the 2000 years, roughly, there have been some inventions of new materials which show these so-called magnetocaloric effect not only at very low temperatures, but around room temperature. And a lot of effort started with these new materials, with this new type of materials, to see if it's possible to use them for domestic cooling or for industrial cooling at temperatures around room temperature. And I'm not the inventor, but we have done a lot of work to promote this
And
material.
what applications you are working on with this material? Is it like a fridge in the kitchen or
You will see it at the very end of my presentation, if we go through this, where I give a few hints which applications are possible with this type of technology. In principle, it's not limited. Any type of cooling or heat pumping could be done with this type of technology and with these materials. The question is if the one or the other technology or application is more suited because of size or weight or other restrictions. But in principle, you can cool or heat everything you want to with.
Okay, so let's go through your presentation.
So first of all, you see there not only my name, it's Matthias Katter, it's Alexander Barzer. He actually put this presentation together, but today he is unfortunately hindered, so I took over for him. So go on to the next slide, please. A few words to Vakuumschmelze. Vakuumschmelze is an industrial company located in Hanau, close to Frankfurt in Germany. And we are a company in total about 4,000 employees, and we are dedicated to special magnetic materials. So magnetic solutions starting from the material. So as the name says, Vakuumschmelze, we start from the very beginning. So we start from melting our materials under vacuum from the elements, and then do a lot of soft magnetic materials, permanent magnetic materials, and also special magnetic materials like these magnetocaloric materials I will explain to you. So we have a lot of activities here, customers, patents, 170 different alloys. So it's a real industrial company that you see what is behind this material. So please, next slide. Why magnetic refrigeration? Motivation for this is every one of us is aware that cold, either it's industrial or it's domestic cold, is very essential for the society. the refrigeration market is about $20 billion of dollar in 2020, and that's a really huge market. And the other thing is, all these cooling devices, they need a lot of energy. So there are huge amount of energy dedicated only for cooling, either air conditioning or cooling of foods and so on. And another thing is, at the moment, there are a lot of hurdles with this technology regarding the so-called F-gas regulation. Problem is, a lot of these cooling applications rely on cooling gases, which are fluorinated, so they are environmentally bad. So they give rise to greenhouse effect. There are regulations on the way. You see it on the right side that these gases, they are banned. So there's a lot of problem for the industry to overcome these struggles by replacing these gases with some new technologies where the environment is not harmed. And therefore, alternative technologies are needed, and magnetic refrigeration is one way to solve this problem. So please, next slide. So what is a magnetic heat pump? How does it work? First of all, you should know that the magnetocaloric effect is nothing else than the temperature change, the reversible temperature change of a material if you apply a magnetic field. So if you apply a magnetic field, the temperature of the material on the left side, it's called the MCE, magnetic caloric effect, is increased by some delta. And the other thing is, with this change of magnetization state, there is some entropy change involved. On the right side, you see a chart with the entropy change, which means nothing more than some heat can be extracted or can be absorbed. So next slide, please. And with these two properties, one can build up a cycle. You place a magnetic field on the magnetocaloric material. The material heats up. Then you place some fluid through the material. The heat is extracted to the environment. Then after removal of the magnetic field, the material cools down and you can take the cool to cool something. So that's a thermodynamic cycle. You can see it also on the right side in this cycle, where the yellow point is, the starting point is. So we start with a material at room temperature. Then the next step right beside this is to magnetize the material. The temperature is increasing. Then this increased temperature, the heat is expelled to the environment on the right side of the cycle. Then the material is gone back to the initial temperature. And as soon as the magnetic field is removed, then you see the blue box there, the material is cooled down, and then you can pick up the cold or the heat from some source, from a fridge or from the house you want to cool the air inside. The good thing with this technology is it has several advantages over the actual cooling technology, which is dominated by the compressor cycle. It's not only that there is no greenhouse gases necessary for this process, it's also that this process has a higher energetical efficiency. So higher efficiency means you need less power to prepare these materials or to make these processes. They are not harmful, it's also not noisy. So one thing with the material is you have to exchange the heat with the environment. And to do this, the material has to be brought into a very particular shape. On this simple picture, you see these parallel plates. This means you need some micro heat exchangers, a large surface, small fluid channels, and that's not easy to make. So go on to the next slide. The standard way to make this material, in our case, it's an alloy, intermetallic alloy based on lanthanum, iron, and silicon, is that you start with some molten alloys, you prepare some powder, mix the powders, to blend them to the right composition, and then you press some blocks by powder metallurgical processes, and after sintering you get some semi-finished products, some blocks, and then the normal way is, or the old way would be, to cut the required heat exchangers out of these blocks. But this technology is not very efficient. You lose a lot of material, and it's also very hard to obtain the structures. The structures for these heat exchangers should be in the range of 100 to 200 micrometer. So, and with standard machining, that's a nightmare. So we developed a process to make this material in a much different shape. Next slide, please. Yeah, and this is a process, which is also not unusual in powder metallurgy. So we mix our powder with some binder and some solvent. Then we get a slurry. The slurry is cast on a belt, and then you get some tapes which are dried. And these tapes, due to the plastic deformability of the binder, can be deformed. So we have an embossing process. You see these two fields where the microstructure we want to have, or the shape of the parts, is done by impressing, so embossing of these foils. And these foils are cut into sheets. Then you can stack the sheets one on each other, and you end up with some green parts which have to be put into a thermal treatment. And first of all, the binder has to be removed. Then it's sintered. Then we have a solid material with all these thousands of tiny fluid channels, very easily and directly made in this net shape production process. You may have some additional machining. At the very end, you need some additional loading of hydrogen there, and then you end up with the finished product. So that process is very well suited to make these difficult material into a shape which can be used to make these heat pumps. So next slide, please. So on the top left side, you see such a typical block. I think in the exhibition there are also some pieces available that you can see them at the site. And you see all these tiny micro channels. They are only 200, 300 micrometers in size. That's the key component of this cooling technology. But that's not all you need. You need also some strong magnetic field. And this is generated by neodymium and boron permanent magnets. Man Vacuum Schmelze is not only developing these magnetocaloric materials, we are also the largest producer of neodymium and boron permanent magnets in Europe. So we are also experts in making these permanent magnets and the magnet assemblies. So that's a thing we can provide. So that's our part of the value chain, making these magnetocaloric material, providing permanent magnets, magnet assemblies. But a machine which can pump some heat requires much more. So there's a lot of mechanics, thermodynamics, and so on required. So this is the part which has to be brought in by our partners. So we have a large number of partnerships with sometimes startups, sometimes large companies, which are working on this type of technology. And in total, this results in machines where you can pump some heat. So go to the last slide or next slide. There you see where this technology can be used. Addressable market segments. In principle, you can use it for any type of heat pumping. This might be air conditioning, this might be refrigeration, this might be in different sectors like in the transport sector, in the industry, domestic applications. All these applications at the moment are served by this compressor technology. And that's a very long tradition or a very long development, which has brought the compressor technology to the state they have. So it's quite hard for this new technology to enter these markets. And so we are focusing only on some of these segments. So at the moment, the focus is on light commercial and commercial cooling applications. Examples for these are in the refrigeration line. It's the top line there. Light commercial, what does this mean? So these are some cooling cabinets. If you go to a supermarket and you have some individual cooling cabinets for beverages or for food, then they might be cooled by a small individual cooling unit, some compressor underneath. And this is a potential market also for this magnetocaloric cooling. But there are also the larger commercial ones. A lot of these supermarkets, they have some workshops or plants somewhere remote. So with a much larger cooling capacity, and all the show cabinets are connected with piping. So this is also a very interesting market. This type of business is the people there, they look for the total cost of ownership and not so much on the cost of the equipment itself. So that's easier for such a new technology, especially the high energy efficiency is there a very good selling point. There are also other new, nice, interesting applications on the right side, industrial. If you take this middle picture, these are data centers, for example. And data centers are very important nowadays. There are so many hubs where thousands of servers are located, all of them generating heat, and they have a lot of struggling to cool them down to keep all the industry, all the internet running. So there are many, many applications. Yes, some of them are targeted by some research projects. For example, in Denmark, there's one project for air conditioning in the more domestic side, but most of them are in a demonstrator phase. So there's not a real industrial application up to now, but we are working on. This brings me to the last slide of my presentation. Yeah, we have developed at Vakuumschmelze this magnetocaloric material. We call it CaloriVac, and you can use it for any type of cooling or heat pumping. And at the moment, it's available in a kilogram scale for prototyping. That's the state of the art at the moment. And with our partners, we are on the way to promote this technology. We think it's a very important brick in the picture to deal with the European Green Deal to make a future benefit for cooling and saving of energy and also saving the environment. So I hope I could tell you some new information on this topic. And you, if there are any questions and if there's time, I'm happy to answer.
Yeah, thank you so much. I read something about 40% more efficient than the normal cooling technology. I mean, that's a really a high number. And we have these small blocks, some of them in our exhibition, and we put a lens on it so that you can see the micron channels quite easily. Yeah, all of you are very much invited to come to the show. And now it's time for me to give up to Jonas, who is standing next to me.
Thank you so much, Sasha. And snälla, gå till Innodex nere i D-hallen, för det är grejer att titta på. Precis som vi hörde här så är det jättemycket intressant att dyka djupt i. Och vi har ju dem här nu, det är ju superspännande. Och Sasha, are you ready for some visitors?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, yeah.
I have a run down the
yeah,
stairs.
You have to run. Och vad vi ska göra, vi ska också springa vidare, men vi ska ta ungefär en minuts paus, för då är vi tillbaks härifrån studion. Så vi ses om 60 sekunder.